afforded him the time to do what we know him best for. The printing was no joke. Every letter was a separate block, and the letters would be lined up word by word, sentence by sentence, which is one thing. The problem is that most letters, I mean, what letter's that?
B.
Clearly. What letter's that? Too late. You got to know immediately what that letter is. You can't discern it over time.
You have to get outside.
So, right, you got to move quick, or you're not going to make any money. Guess what letters are in the upper cases over here?
Oh, capital.
Capital letters, lowercase.
That's uppercase and lowercase.
Upper, lowercase. And they're arrayed over there, not unlike your keyboard. So you know where the letters are. You can't take the time, say, oh, that's a B, or maybe it's an S. You gotta know. That's why, like a keyboard, you know where the letters are. Because to set the type of a page, just like this, might, if you know what you're doing, might take 6 hours. That's if you know what you're doing. So this is the labor intensive part. Then we can get rolling. You want ink, generally. It comes in handy with this stuff. So you get this ink on these letters by and paper 200 years ago is made from what? Anybody know?
Linen.
Linen is right. Cloth, cotton. Cotton's a little fibrous. But this is modern cotton, which is still very expensive and quality. So you rub this down here, keep everything steady. Down there, you roll it under. What's this machine called?
Press.
It's a press. Who are the press?
Names. The news.
The news media. This is why we call it the press. Now, it's a long page, so I've got to do this twice. I'm going to put this here. So, press. Let's see what happened here. Up into four and sell them. These are Franklin ditties. And we're not quite done because this has to be hung to dry. By, no doubt, an apprentice. And that would be done for everyone, every time. Questions?